incumbent, a leader with proven skills. He's the man with a track record of victories, most notably 13 Grand Slam titles. Murat Safin is the challenger, a candidate with lots of potential as yet unrealized. He's brimming with power and promise. The two meet at this week's Campaign Stop, the Tennis Masters Series in Toronto, next on ESPN2. Welcome, everybody, to ESPN2's coverage of the Tennis Masters Series from Toronto. Quarterfinal action, and tonight's featured matchup, Murat Safin, the young Russian, taking on Pete Sampras, one of the best players in the world. Weather here today, 68 degrees, breezy, but absolutely beautiful weather for tennis. Hello, everyone. I am Melavia Washington alongside Luke Jensen. And Luke, before we get into tonight's matchup, let's talk a little bit about some of the other matchups earlier today. Patrick Rafter, a guy who I thought had a great chance of winning this tournament, took on a really hot Jiří Novák.
But the question mark was Rafter's shoulder, Mal. So many times with that surgically repaired shoulder, Rafter wasn't really ready to go. In today's match, he went down in three sets. He made 36 unforced errors, 15 in the third set. Jiří Novák came out slow. Look at the play from Rafter, stinging shots, using his athletic ability around the net, knocking off volleys.
A lot of us saw Jiří Novák a couple of months ago in Davis Cup in Los Angeles taking down Pete Sampras in the first match, and it's shot like these right here that got him back into this match after being down a set.
His footwork is amazing. Jiří Novák's able to scoot around the baseline and knock off shots. Nice backhand. Drills the forehand and really having Rafter all over the court.
And with that backhand error, Jiří Novák moves into the semifinal with a 6-2 victory over Patrick Rafter. And this is what Patrick had to say about this loss.
You know, just today, it was working well. It was working fine. I lost a little bit of rhythm on the serve. And Jiří is someone who returns very well. And so you don't want to serve into his hitting zone. And I just couldn't get out of his zone there. And, you know, he played very well, and just probably wasn't as sharp as I had been in the other matches. All I know is that Cincinnati will be out, and then I'll just be taking each week at a time, and I won't be back until I know it's right.
And Luke, Wayne Ferreira playing some of the best tennis of this year, taking on Yevgeny Kafelnikov, a guy who was in the finals of the Aussie Open earlier this year but hasn't won a tournament yet this year.
Well, Wayne Ferreira hasn't won a tournament since 1996. It was this tournament here in Toronto, the Canadian Open. And it's the footwork from Wayne Ferreira that's really picked up his game. In my opinion, you see Wayne setting up for shots now, mixing it up here during this point. But watch the footwork where he passes to Kafelnikov.
We've always known that Wayne Ferreira has had the great talent, but he's never been able to do it at the bigger tournaments. And with an ace like that, that's what got him into this semifinal, a straight set victory over Yevgeny Kafelnikov. And some of the other matches, some of the tournament summaries thus far. Look at Harold Levy, the Israeli, 133 in the world. He is into the semifinals, taking on Jiří Novák tomorrow. And Wayne Ferreira, 20 in the world. He will be taking on the winner of tonight's match between Pete Sampras and Murat Safin. Yeah. And Pete Sampras, he's a guy, he's on a bit of a roll. I think he started out kind of slow in this tournament, but his last match yesterday, he breezed through pretty quickly.
Yeah, Pistol Pete's really starting to feel the groove again, hitting the big serves. And most of the time, he's going to dominate. He knows that if he plays his game, he's going to win. He feels strong. He's warming up for his match right now, trying to loosen things up. But he's playing a guy who he can't dictate against, Murat Safin. They last played in 1998 in the round of 16. Safin was a young Russian, still is a young Russian. But this is Safin's second time facing the big Pete Sampras. This guy brings a lot of firepower from the serve, from the net, and from the ground strokes.
I think Murat Safin has a very good chance of winning this match if he can overcome his fear of Pete Sampras. Pete Sampras used to be one of his idols. When we come back, Pete Sampras will be taking on this young 20-year-old Russian, Murat Safin. It'll be a good one. Tennis Masters Series Toronto quarterfinal action. This winner of this match is the last semifinalist in this event. Murat Safin taking on number 2 seed, the highest seed left, in big serving Pete Sampras. These two have played just one time before, a couple years ago at the US Open. Pete, 28 years old. born in the D.C. area, living in Los Angeles right now.
I really like the way Pete Sampras has really set himself up for the summer swing. He's never won a Canadian Open. I really think this is on his mind, a guy who's really wants to put his stamp on the game. Of course, probably the best player who ever lived on the men's side of the ball. Plays with tremendous confidence.
It's one of the great things about Pete Sampras. He is a guy that plays with great confidence, confidence in himself and his game every time he goes out there. And this is what he says about some of his goals for the rest of his career.
Goal is to try to add on to it and, you know, to do well at the majors and keep on enjoying it and hopefully play at the highest level. You know, I'm not so consumed with being ranked number one. It is about going into the majors feeling good and feeling confident and trying to win them.
And Pete Sampras, as everyone knows, one of the best players in the world who has ever picked up a tennis racket. 13 Grand Slam titles, which is a record. And Luke, here in the Masters Series, also a record with 11 Masters Series titles.
You're going to see there's a board right in front of the chair of Pete Sampras to the side, and they have the number of shields, and you'll see 11 up there. I mean, that's very impressive because you've been knocking off guys like Becker, McEnroe, Edberg, the best of all time. He's been through them. Look at all those things. Safin's got zero. Look at this. Look at that.
11 shields, and Murat Safin, he was in the finals of Hamburg earlier this year, losing to Gustavo Kuerten. He's 20 years old, a big guy, big power hitters, big serve, explosive personality out on the court when things aren't necessarily going his way. Good match record thus far in 2000, 36-19 with a couple of tournament wins in Barcelona and Mallorca earlier this year.
Now, the book on Safin is that he does better on clay because he's a big guy, likes the time that the ball gives him to set up on clay. On hard court, he doesn't have that time.
But with the kind of game that he does play, he should, over the course of his career, become an extremely good hard court player.
Now, I always think it's a mentality. I mean, of course, you grow into the faster surfaces if you're a slow court player, but you have to have the mentality to go after your opponents. Look at the way he sets up. This is 6'4". Off the backhand side, rips it. I think this is such an explosive matchup, because it's not often we see Pete Sampras getting dominated by a player. And not that this guy, Pete Sampras, is get pushed around a lot, but he doesn't play guys that hit as big. You know, when he plays Krajicek, he gets pushed around a little bit. When he plays, you know, Andre Agassi, at times, Andre can push him around. Safin has the ability to do that if he gets on fire.
Because he does have that power. Serve out wide for Pete Sampras takes him to 30-15.
I remember watching a young Safin play Andre Agassi in 1998 in the opening round of the French Open. It was the first time I'd ever seen Andre Agassi being pushed around from the baseline. I mean, normally Andre was always the guy dictating. Then this was the first guy that I'd seen that pushed him around.
An overhead winner by Pete Sampras. One love here early in the first set. And Murat Safin, who says that win over Andre Agassi at the French Open, he said that was one of his biggest wins, biggest moments of his career. And taking a look at the semifinal draw, at the top of the draw, Harlan Levy, a qualifier from Israel.
Yeah, he took out Golmar, who Golmar took out Agassi in the very first round, and then you had Novak. Novak's playing very strong. I mean, that top, in my opinion, is between Ferreira, Safin, and Sampras right now, the title. Novak and Levy are playing for second.
Safin to serve. Forehand error off the racket of Pete Sampras, 15 love.
When you're watching Pete Sampras from the baseline,
Watch how he tries to control the middle of the court. If you're an opponent of Pete Sampras, keep the ball out of the middle because he will take his forehand and start driving it to the corners, putting you on the defensive.
See, that once again, the ball's not to the sideline now, and what happens is he sets up for it and he explodes.
And usually what you see is Pete Sampras trying to run around that backhand, but there he chose to stay right on it and drive it up the line for the winner. Alexander Volkov.
Good. What great timing.
Murat Safin's coach. He has recently switched coach. Coaches earlier this year was Andrei Chesnokov, and here's Safin's road to the quarterfinals. Alexander Volkov, his coach, one of the handfuls of Russian players that have played on the tour throughout the 1990s. His previous coach, Andrei Chesnokov, also played on the tour. Double break point for Sampras.
That's the big serve we're talking about. Lots of leverage at 6'4", hitting down.
Still a break point. And even though Pete Sampras missed that, that's something chipping and coming in is something I've seen, especially in his last few matches. He did that a lot against Sarkis Sargsyan in his third round match.
Seems like the injuries have really got him into this Paul Anacone, his coach type of mentality. When Paul Anacone played a lot of smash and crash, attacking the second serve. Now Pete's doing that, and there's Paul Anacone right there. Kind of bunt and run, chip in charge type of mentality to keep the point short.
Well, as explosive as Pete Sampras can be, not only when serving and returning, you would think he would want to get into the net a little bit more when he's receiving. And with that ace, Murat Safin, his second ace, third ace of the match, he ties this first set at one game all.
I think one problem Pete Sampras does have is that he has too many options to go to. I mean, if you're a guy like Paul Anacone or Luke Jensen, you have one option, get to the net. You can't stay at the baseline. But Pete Sampras can stay at the baseline. He can go to the net. He can serve big. He can return big.
Pete Sampras has to be like a major league manager in baseball. He's got to push the right buttons at the right time.
But he can get into a little trouble, I think, if he... Taking another look at this point, easy volley for Pete into the open court. He can get into a little bit of trouble if he gets into a mode of just staying at the baseline. Pete taking a long look at that out call.
And that's a major outburst for Pete Sampras. I mean, that's the most you're going to get out of him. Maybe a word or two, but that's about it.
Awesome. Lots of zip on that forehand volley. Setting up the sweet touch
for the killer backhand. The road for Sampras. Alami. Alami tagged him the first time they played back in Doha, Qatar a number of years ago. As you can see, the score is getting stronger and stronger.
His toughest matchup, 7-6 in the third in the first round against Lodra.
Unknown Frenchman. Known now.
Another unreturnable.
Book on Murat Safin off the return size. You want to try to stretch him out. He's a big guy. If you get him really stretched on that forehand side, he can make some errors. He loves that two-hand backhand. Well, that's a clear ace in my opinion.
And two times in a row on this side, Pete taking a long look. And rarely does Pete do that. Steve Ulrich, the chair umpire for this evening's match, agreeing with the call.
He's not going to overrule that one. That's too far away from his chair.
But Pete wins the point anyways, and he holds serve to take a 2-1 lead here early in the first set against Murat Safin. Safin to serve right after this. Earlier this year at the Ericsson Open in Miami, Pete Sampras had his only Masters Series title this year against Gustavo Kuerten.
Look at this play from Pete Sampras running around. Gustavo really stretched Pete Sampras. The four sets, Gustavo and that Brazilian crowd really pushing the American to the limit.
And one thing I liked about Gustavo Kuerten in this match, even though he lost this match, he was really upset after this loss. He really thought he had a great opportunity to win this match. 7-6 in the last three sets in that match. Pete winning that title. He's won that title many a times. But back here, Murat Safin serving 1-2 to Pete Sampras.
A lot of people still trying to get into the court. Remember now with new changing system, we play three straight games at the beginning of each set. A lot of people don't get a chance to get into the court.
And a look at the Champions Race of 2000. Gustavo Kuerten overtook Magnus Norman this week. If Pete wins this title, he will be number one on the Champions Race. He is currently number three in the Champions Race.
This is one thing that Pete Sampras does to opponents, especially baseliners. What happens is he lulls you into kind of like a sleep from the baseline. He doesn't put a lot of pace on it, changes the spins, and you on the baseline start to kind of fall asleep out there. You've got to be awake. You've got to be really focused in and playing your game.
Bridget Wilson, Pete Sampras' fiance.
That's what I'm talking about. You got to be quick on your feet. Murat Safin this time, recognizing the short ball, gets up to it and rips a forehand inside out.
15-0. Good wide serve from Safin. Already three aces in this match.
Watch the mechanics for Murat. For a big guy, he has a lot of leverage, but look, not many hitches in that serve. Sets up, falls back, then goes after it. Falls into the court. Watch where his body ends up after he hits the ball, towards his target.
Bit of an ugly return from Pete Sampras, 40-15.
It's Murat's girlfriend. I do not know her name. I have no idea.
And the fourth ace for Murat Safin. And he ties this match at 2-2.
I love the way he brings down the heat. Once again, focused in on his target, Murat really consistently tagging that first serve early in this match. On that backhand volley. Pistol Pete using the 1-2 combination.
Making it look very easy.
Yeah, and it's so difficult to do that. He's just inside the service line and he stabs at it.
First volley from Pete Sampras. He said after his third round match against Sargsyan, he said he was pretty impressed with the way he had volleyed. He says when he comes off of the grass courts of Europe after playing on grass for a whole month where he's hitting a lot of volleys and half volleys and really going side to side when he's up at the net, he feels like he's volleying extremely well right now.
Pete's also healthy. I think during the Wimbledon Championships, he was severely injured, just limping through that draw, pulling out that tournament. Now he's healthy, he's running after matches. And when you don't have to worry about injuries and nagging aches and pains, you are, you know, you have the freedom and the confidence to stick volleys and stick ground strokes and dig out shots.
Good defense.
Here's a stat for you now. It's only 2-all in the first set. Safin's got 4 aces. As we watch Pistol Pete turn around and try to rip this backhand.
Not a very high percentage play from Sampras.
But Sampras using combination with the volleys to win his points because he has no aces so far in this match.
Solid return from Murat Safin gives him his first break point here at 2-all.
The return was right at the shoelaces of Pete Sampras with a lot of heat.
Good combination. Good deep first serve, pinning your opponent to the corner, forcing the weak return, knocking off the volley.
I think that serve, the pace actually got Murat Safin a little bit because he wasn't extremely stretched out on the serve, on the return. But the sheer pace got him, not able to hit an effective return. Back to deuce.
The sheer pace from Murat Safin's return on that point rattles Pistol Pete Sampras.
Another opportunity for a break early here in the first for Safin.
It's important for Safin to keep the backswing short.
He can find it. Great time for his first ace. Good rhythm on the serve.
And everybody knows that's something that makes Pete Sampras, is when he is down break points like that, how many times have you seen his serve bail him out of situations?
Before the match started, we were talking about that, how amazing it is, the timing that Pistol Pete can do this. Time and timing at break point down, when he really needs a point, he can really crease the lines with that serve.
And strangely enough, when we were watching him warm up, we didn't see him hit any serves. He hit a few ground strokes, a few returns of serves. Didn't hit any serves, though.
I'd say 99% of the players out there could not do that. Another example. I mean, you and I went to the IMAX of Michael Jordan today. I mean, this is the equivalent, tennis-wise, of Michael Jordan. I mean, this guy has all the answers in clutch times.
And with his serve, he saves a third break point back to deuce. Last.
One thing Murat Safin can do, really work on Pete Sampras. You make Pete Sampras play a lot of shots, make him work out there. Pete Sampras is vulnerable to the conditioning aspect. He's trying to get stronger, trying to get better, but he is just coming off an injury.
Second.
Another example, Murat Safin looks very comfortable taking that return of serve and driving it right back at Pete Sampras.
Pete Sampras not doing enough with that second serve. It hung up there. 6 unreturned serves.
Pete Sampras is a rhythm player, especially on the serve. He loves to get a good groove and a good pop.
Second serve for Safin. He wants to put this return in play. A
Sampras taking another long look at it, but from our vantage point, it did look like he was wrong. With a few errors, Pete Sampras goes down a break early in the first set, 3-2. Tennis Masters Series Toronto, Murat Safin, the 8th seed, up 3-2, a break on Pete Sampras. And tomorrow on ESPN at 1 p.m. Eastern, semifinal action here from Toronto. And then tomorrow night on ESPN2, 1 a.m. Eastern, 10 p.m. on the West Coast, the second of the two semifinals matches. That will be myself and Luke Jensen. So 4 p.m. on ESPN and 1 a.m. on ESPN2. For more, log on to ESPN.com.
Thank you.
Pistol Pete looking at that last call. I think he was confused because he saw Safin break to the forehand side where he's going to hit it, decided to change his mind the last second, shanked it. Just not deep enough. Pete Sampras having the opportunity in that second serve to dice and dash.
And I like the idea, I just don't like the execution from Sampras. Too short, as you said.
But this is the type of matchup that I want to see Pete Sampras face. So many times he does dictate. Now he's getting some hot lunch from the Russian.
And being dictated too.
Come on back.
You look at the players that have winning records against Pete Sampras, very few. Richard Krajicek's one of them is because he can serve so big, get some free points, kind of scare Pete Sampras at times. This Russian has the ability. Look at that serve. Over 200 kilometers an hour, 201 on the speed gun.
Another big serve, 30-15 for Safin.
Setting up the ground stroke to get up and knock off the overhead.
He got some air on this ball. Good approach shot by Sampras.
And we have liftoff.
He almost took out that lines person with that overhead.
And the back fence. That's what I want to see from the Russian. When you have the opportunity to come in, use that big 6'4" frame, swing at that volley, come up, change the grips, then knock off the back end. Good fundamental tennis.
Definitely not his strength in his game, though, coming into the net and volleying and being comfortable up there.
He looks a little stiff doing it. A classic match Safin played against Courier in Atlanta during Davis Cup. He was smoking Courier and then got stiff, got tight. And ended up losing that match. But this is what I like about the maturing Safin. We're watching a young Russian kind of come into his own, playing, you know, one of his idols, a guy he considered a god in Pete Sampras. He's attacking the guy, attacking the Wimbledon champion.
He definitely considered Pete one of his heroes when he was growing up. Murat Safin says, "I saw him when I was 11 years old. He was like a god to me. Now I see his name in all the draws and it's more normal to me. It will be a tough match, but I will have a chance if I play my tennis." That's a quote from Safin. So Pete has always been a hero to him. Murat Safin, only 20 years old. 36 wins thus far here in 96. Look how he's gradually gotten better.
But 98 was ranking. The 98 was the big breakthrough. Everyone started noticing the guy.
Beating Agassi at the French in the first round, then reaching the round of 16, losing to Pete Sampras at the US Open.
He won his first tournament of his career last year in Boston, also on a hard court, even though he's known a little bit more as a clay court player.
Left Russia to move to Spain, grew up on you know, didn't grow up, but basically learned his traditional teenage tennis on the red clay courts in Espanyol, Barcelona.
And his mother was a tennis player. His mother started him out early.
Now, as you know, behind every tennis player on the men's and women's tour, you have a parent there that pushed, didn't push you, but got you out on the court, hitting balls with you at a young age.
That was definitely the case with me and my father, getting us out there at a young age. Same with you.
Same with me. I mean, I've done a survey of the top 20 players and talking to them, and they'll say, you know, there was somebody in my family, an older brother, older sister, an uncle, someone in the family that got you out there hitting the ball, getting the racket in your hand.
Easy high forehand put away for Sampras, takes him to 40-15.
The fundamentals, I mean, he's starting to change gears, Pete Sampras. He's not trying to blow things by him. He'd love a few more aces. Pete Sampras only has one ace in this match so far. He's just feeling his way now. He's down a break. He wants to get the rhythm back on a serve.
Half volley by Sampras. Murat Safin is having some success with Sampras' serve. He's been able to hit a couple of winners off the return, get the ball down in front of Sampras, so he can't do a whole lot with some of the volleys, but he still has a game point. And with his second ace, Pete Sampras holds serve, and he is still down a break. And when we come back, Murat Safin, he'll be serving up 4-3. Tennis Masters Series from Toronto, Murat Safin up a break 4-3 alongside Luke Jensen. I am Malavia Washington. Murat Safin already with four aces. Pete Sampras not really being able to make a dent with his return of serve game yet.
Well, he's getting lots of chances, lots of looks like that on the second serve. This time the return's a little bit deeper, but it's the passing shots from the Russian that have been so deadly. Look at this. Again, setting up good quickness off the baseline, getting the time to rip the passing shots.
Perfect execution from the Russian.
Well, Safin's only hitting 40% first serve, so Pete is getting a lot of looks on seconds. Once again, another second serve to look at. Oh, that's nice. Recognizing the short ball, using his transition game, Pete Sampras gets up to that short ball and knocks it. See, he gets up to it, doesn't let the ball drop, hits it at waist height. Good fundamental tennis.
15-all.
Another missed first serve. That's three. Let's see Pete Sampras zip this return.
Trying to step up the pace on the forehand, making a bad error, pulling that ball wide.
One Achilles heel, and I see this a lot when you watch Pete Sampras, is that high backhand. When he gets in trouble, he doesn't have a lot of power, a lot of racket head speed when he's hitting that backhand, so baseliners can exploit it.
Big serve by Safin, 40-15.
Well, Safin has such a fluid motion, almost like Pete Sampras in a sense, where it doesn't look like he's really working hard to hit it, but that ball's coming out like a cannon.
Safin not recognizing that short ball early enough. He should have been up a little closer to that. That was not a difficult shot.
You have a split second, as you know, Mel, to really jump on that short ball and take it offensively. This time he got a step late and shanked it.
And he finally gets a first serve in and holds on the serve. He is up 5-3 in the first set. Pete Sampras serving to stay in this first set now.
And this is where it's fun to watch Pete Sampras, because right now in his mind he's thinking, how can I get my serve back going? How can I break this guy? This is where the strategy comes in. It's easy to play when you're ahead, when you're Pete Sampras dictating. Now he's not dictating. He has to stop a fresh, hot Russian. You see, Pete's not getting any free points. He only has two aces so far. He's serving at 50% first serves. And Safinov, the first and second serve return, is making him play over and over.
Sampras, 4 of 11 when serving volleying on his second serve. That is the difference in this match right now, and it is why he is down a break 5-3.
And I think now, because he's had a fairly easy road, he had a very tough first round match against an unknown opponent, and then he's played a couple of easy matches against guys who didn't hit the ball very strong. Sarkisian doesn't hit the ball that strong. I mean, he's playing guys where he can dictate. Now this guy hits it with lead in the strings.
An ace from Pete Sampras, number 3 on the match. Takes him to 40 love.
And when you step up and you're playing a player that plays with so much pace, it's hard to adjust sometimes. It takes you a little while to get the feel.
Two aces in a row for Pete Sampras. Number 4 on the match. Takes him to 5-4, but Murat Safin is still up a break. He'll be serving for the first set when we come back right after this. Murat Safin serving for the first set, 5-4, up on Pete Sampras here in the quarterfinals. But tomorrow on ESPN, second round coverage of the Coldwell Banker Burnett Classic presented by Cadillac. Defending champion Hale Irwin finished the first round 7-under, along with Alan Doyle and Ed Dockery. Tomorrow should be very, very exciting. Join us at 2:30 Eastern. For more, log on to ESPN.com, a part of the Go Network.
Can't wait to get back on the links myself, start driving some.
Easy put away for Pete Sampras, just slams it into the stands.
But Pete Sampras moving the ground strokes around now, and that's what he has to do. We start unnerving the young Russian.
An opportunity for Pistol.
With the winner on the first point, the error from Safin, love 30. I must say, from our vantage point, Luke, I have to agree with that correction. Obviously, Pete Sampras does not.
Pete Sampras really wanted to call, doesn't like the way it was changed. Steve Ulrich in the chair is not going to change that. It's too far away. But Pete doing the right thing as we look at Steve Ulrich right there.
Ace number 5 for Murat Safin, but it was a very quick overrule by the umpire. By the linesman, I should say. And with that serve, he gets it back to 30 all.
Pete struggling just to get the racket back. As you can see, he's just trying to get his feet going.
For Sampras, you have Safin where you want him at the net. He's setting up for a back and he just shanks it.
The first set point for Murat Safin, 40-30. Come back from love 30 in this game. Backhand error. Pete Sampras loses the first set to young Russian Murat Safin, 6-4. After a little bit of trouble in that last game serving
for the set. Down love 30. Came back strong with a couple of big serves. See if he can hold on and get into the semifinals. More right after this. Up 6-4, 3-4, he is serving here, trying to get into the semifinals. And next week, from Cincinnati, Tennis Masters Series, the 7th Masters Series event of 2000, 1 p.m. Eastern, 10 a.m. on the West Coast, this Monday, from Cincinnati, ESPN.com.
Getting my Skyline Chili ready, got my Spyway going, check out the Reds. I love that tournament. That's a great stop.
Just to show how tough it is to repeat here on the tour. Look at Pete Sampras in 99 and 2000. Will he repeat in Cincinnati?
Well, the LA thing was entirely due to his injury to his left calf. Severe tendonitis from the Wimbledon Championships. Didn't play Davis Cup in Spain because of it.
And now a little trouble for Murat Safin. Love 30 after throwing in a double fault. Pete attacking on that second serve, putting a little pressure on him. Let's see if he can hold on.
This is where the experience, you know, you're Pete Sampras, Wimbledon champion, forcing the issue, looking for your opportunity, coming out of a tight situation in your last service game. Sampras playing a little cat and mouse out there now, going cross court, changing the spin, a little top spin, a little underspin, getting a nice fat one, the slice down the line, forcing the forehand air.
And Pete Sampras, double break point. He has not broken serve yet today, 0 for 2. And he gets another second serve. Will he try to put the pressure on him and come in with the backhand slice? And a fist pump from Pete Sampras. He did. He didn't hit that great of a return inside the service line, but it got the job done. And Bridget Wilson, his girlfriend, his fiancée, was pretty happy about it.
Well, she's in the toughest spot with the coaching staff. I mean, that's nerves right there when you can't do anything about it and you're watching your guy go out there and tough it out.
And in that last game, remember when you mentioned how big that 15-30 point was to give Safin double break point? Pete got that. Got that point. Now he's serving for the set. Just a few minutes later.
So nice. Swinging out wide, creating the open court, nailing the backhand volley. Great technique. Let me take you back to the Wimbledon final against Rafter. He's down 7-6, and it's 6-all. He's down 4-1, too many breaks. Rafter loses the next 2 points on a serve, has an easy setter, misses the forehand pass, and Sampras rolls on. You get so few opportunities against Pete Sampras.
Once again, that second serve setting right up for the big 6'4" Safin. He pounds that backhand, Luke.
It's just not a way. See how right in the center of the box? Get it out to the sideline. So many times, you can get away with it in junior tennis, collegiate tennis, but in pro tennis, you gotta move the ball to the sidelines. See the difference in there? 3 inches from the sideline. Busting away with a lot of slice.
Pete Sampras, another ace, number 8 on the match. He pulls even with Safin, who also has 8 aces. Pete Sampras, 2 points from the second set.
good body, good jammer, just misses it long. Good strategy.
Well left by Pete Sampras, takes him to 40-15, double set point.
Once again, Sampras goes right to the body on the second serve, but has a little bit more authority on the second serve. If you are going to go down the middle of the box, you better have some smoke behind it.
Second serve by Sampras, and he evens this match at one set all. He lost the first set 6-4, wins the second set 6-3. A little shaky there at 3-3 in the second set, but Pete Sampras showed why. He is Pete Sampras and got the job done. Third set action coming up right after this. And earlier this year, Pete Sampras in the finals of Wimbledon, his seventh Wimbledon title, taking on Patrick Rafter.
Pete Sampras was out playing Rafter the entire match, but it was shots like that that pulled him through. He was down a set. In the second set tiebreaker, he's down 4-1, and he came through, able to lift his game when he needed it.
6-2 in the fourth set. Pete Sampras, his parents were there in the crowd, have not seen him play very much at all, had never been to Wimbledon. Saw him win his record 13th Grand Slam title. An amazing feat. Not only because it was his 13th title, but also I think because of the pressure that was around him every Grand Slam that he played. Okay, he's talking about the record. And to actually be able to, under all of that pressure, be able to play in the final against a hot Patrick Rafter, and there you see it, Pete Sampras, 13 Grand Slam titles.
Emerson, Borg, Laver. What a great list.
To put that record, 13, into perspective, as great as an Andre Agassi is, he only has 6. Stefan Edberg and Boris Becker each had 6. Lindell, 7 Grand Slams, as well as McEnroe and Connors. And here he is, Pete Sampras, twice as many as those greats.
But you look at Agassi, he had to run into Sampras a bunch of times. You know, a lot of these guys who may, you know, might have had more titles, you know, Becker might have had more, but, you know, Sampras just ringing them up.
Backhand down the line. Pete Sampras just lines it up and fires a backhand down the line for a clean winner. Back to 30-all.
Sampras has his opponent on the ropes a little bit right now. And Safin comes back with a great ace wide. Not a lot of depth on it, and you don't want that on the slice. You want to bring it closer to the net and swing it wide.
And look where Safin is serving on this first serve. Standing way out wide on that first serve on the ad court for Safin. He holds on one game to love here early in the third set. I think it's very crucial early here in this set, because it seems like Pete Sampras, last couple of games in the second set, started getting into a little groove. He broke Safin for the first time, hit a couple of aces.
And it's important for Safin not to think about what happened in that one service game where he had 15-30. He had an opportunity to pass and really create some break points, some opportunities to break this match open.
And I think right now this third set is setting itself up to be a great third set, because Pete Sampras looks like he has his form back a little bit better than he did in the first set, and Murat Safin still playing good tennis.
he found a couple of answers, especially off the backhand side. If he can get his slice over to Safin's backhand and keep it low with some authority, he's going to be in the points and maybe use his forehand or some transition action to get to the net.
Smart pass from Safin. Not trying to rip it, not trying to really go for a lot, putting a lot of toss to get the ball low.
Sampras not able to do anything with it. Back to 15-all.
Right on top of that return. Very quick for a big guy for that first step.
Pete Sampras, 15-30 on his serve. And if you ask me, Luke, that is Pete Sampras' favorite serve on the ad court right up the tee. Watch how many times throughout any match when Pete Sampras needs a big first serve that he goes right up the tee.
And it's so hard to read because that toss is in the same spot. He can go wide with it to the body.
Good play from Sampras. Hits a nice first serve and gets jammed a little bit on the forehand side. It's a tough forehand volley. Doesn't swing it, just bunts it.
Game point for Sampras.
Little good fortune with the net court on the volley, but he takes it to 1-all. Wants Safin to serve.
Smart play from Sampras. Instead of driving the volley deep this time, he decides to take a little off, try to angle the ball. Makes Safin run some miles for the shot. Sampras was surprised at the short ground stroke from Safin. Caught off guard and was kind of like forced into chipping and charging and missing the approach.
Usually when Pete Sampras plays, he
can usually work his way into a point where he can eventually start hitting his forehand as he's backing into the ad court corner. But with the pace on Safin's serve and on his ground strokes, he's not able to do that.
Points from Sampras.
He's not too happy with those results. 40 love for Safin.
Game Safin, the love game for him is up 2-1. Here in the third set, Pete Sampras will be serving.
Now let's watch these two guys put a little bit more zip in your serve. Watch these two guys. Very common. As we watch Pete Sampras wind up, no hesitation. See how that racket never stops. Good racket head speed, and then he explodes into it. Now watch the young rush on the other side. This is going to develop a little bit more pace in your shot. Just continue the racket head all the way through. No hitches. He winds up and cracks it. Try this in the backyard, at the public parks, or at the country club. It'll give you more zip into your first or second serve.
Both of these guys getting off the ground on their serve. Beautiful shot of the moon here in one of the great cities of the room, of the world, Toronto.
Home of the Sky Dome.
For the unreturned serve, Safin really mixing them up, as we had said earlier. Even on both the ad and the deuce. 10 unreturnables, Sampras about the same. Pete Sampras to serve, 1-2, third set.
Safin likes that backhand cross-court passing shot, but he wasn't set up for it this time. Normally, if he's hitting it well, he's able to set up, hit off the front foot, get some balance. This time, on a total dead run.
Safin got there, wasn't able to do anything with it.
Alexander Volkov. Really chilling. He's got to be very happy with his player's play.
I think he'll be very happy if his player can get a break of serve right here.
I'm really impressed with his mental toughness. I mean, the way he's been able to, you know, play Pete Sampras, have a good balanced attack. And the returns. I mean, this is not a typical Sampras match where we see just bang, 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 and it's over.
Well, the guy is getting a lot of returns in the court, making him play.
There's Christina Torrance, the girlfriend of Murat Safin from Spain.
Once again, getting the return down off of a first serve from Sampras. So from 30 love, it is back to 30 all.
Keep that guy away from me, okay? The police, you know, I'm trying to stay low key here in Toronto.
Some of the security guards throughout the stadium, a packed stadium. Sampras would have loved that call. 49 of 69 returns he's gotten in play. How many times did that happen against Pete Sampras?
That's pretty. Taking the pace from Murat Safin's return and just using kind of feathery touch going down the line.
Good technique. See how he gets down low for it, doesn't bend it to waist, bends with his knees. Split step, bends at the knees, rolls it down the line.
No racket head movement whatsoever.
Sampras holds on, two games all. Bridget Wilson trying to do everything she can from the box.
Girlfriend's getting a lot of air time out here. But it's the action on the court that's really impressing me. The return side from Safin. You knew he was going to serve big. His mental toughness for a young kid coming out here.
Two games all.
That's a great point from both players, Luke. Ross Safin just scrambling, going with this one with both hands. Sampras with the stab.
You are not number one in the world six straight years in a row without doing something right. And this guy has the ability to raise the level of his game in certain points of matches when he needs it.
And for the second time in a row, Safin is down love 30 on his serve. Little fist pump from Safin, 15-30.
Way to take your time, Murat. the right ball. He's looking for the ball with the least amount of fuzz. That's going to travel faster through the air. That's wind resistance. That's aerodynamically sound. He got the right ball from the ball kid.
Ace number 11 from Safin. Could not have come at a better time.
He took his time, really composed himself, thought about the shot he wanted.
And once again, the cross court backhand from Safin.
This is where it's so important, really, look at the scouting port. In the big situations, cover the guy's favorite shot. This time, Safin was set up deep in the court for that backhand pass and connects.
That's good pressure tennis right there by Safin. A big ace, a big backhand, and a big forehand to end that game. He is up 3-2 in the third set. Sampras will be serving right after this. One set all, Pete Sampras down 3-2 here in the third set, but he will be serving. Some of the results from earlier today. Yuri Novak taking down Patrick Rafter, 3-6, 7-6, and 6-2. And the qualifier, Harlan Levy, taking out Gomard. Gomard is the man that took out Andre Agassi in the first round, and Wayne Ferreira defeating Kafelnikov, 6-3, 7-6. Levy taking on Novak in the semifinals. And Wayne Ferreira taking on the winner of this match right here.
Now, this was in the last game. Look at the reaction. I was talking about mental toughness, and this guy's mental toughness can be in check. Look, he's just getting frustrated. This time he gets pumped. This is the roller coaster ride of a young, inexperienced player. And I would show this as like a tape, a training tape for young players, and especially for Murat Safin. If I was Alexander Volkov coaching this guy, hey, look at this. I mean, it's good to be positive. Once in a while, I get frustrated. But look at that's in one game. That's way too much. And you notice when Safin started doing that, it was set early. In the middle of the second set, when he had some, you know, opportunities, he lost those opportunities, and that's when mentally he started to flay a little bit.
But he's really staying pretty composed. He hasn't thrown his racket one time yet, which is surprising for Safin, to tell you the truth. 40 love, Sampras.
He's going to the Olympics for racket throwing. That's a new exhibition sport in Sydney.
Double fault for Pete Sampras. Probably won't matter. He was up 40 love, still has two game points.
We call that a trash point. You know, basically, if you're going to double fault, that's the ideal time to do it.
His second of the match. And another first serve for Sampras. He pulls even at three games all. Really getting down to crunch time, Luke. It'll be interesting to see in this game if Pete gets a few second serves, if he's really going to try to put the pressure on Safin, use the backhand slice to come in.
Pete Sampras, obviously with 13 Grand Slams, owns the term Moneyball. This guy trying to get a sniff of Moneyball here. Playing big in big situations.
But Safin's serving with new balls right now. Service winner. Out wide, 15 love.
Murat Safin getting
caught in that cat and mouse game. He's got to stay with the Sampras back and keep going there. Pete wants to go cross court, do it all day. Don't get baited into going to Sampras's forehand because you're going to lose that point. It's one thing when you, I'm sorry, Mal, when you're hitting over 100 mile an hour first serve, but in the ground stroke rally.
Another serve out wide takes Safin to 30-15.
Tell me, has Safin passed down the line one time in this match? He continually goes cross court.
I haven't seen it, and Sampras doesn't seem to be picking up on it. Both, I mean, almost every time Sampras, you know, is always left kind of stabbing or diving after that passing shot instead of kind of reading it.
Passing shot by Sampras, and Safin holds on. It's getting down to crunch time. He is up 4-3 here in the third set. Sampras will be serving. He'll have to do a little bit better than that drop volley right there. And Murat Safin, one set all and up 4-3 in the third set. Pete Sampras to serve, but on Sunday, live at 4. Murat Safin, a big soccer fan. His team in Moscow, the Moscow Spartak. He follows very closely. As do many of the European players
they
on tour.
It. Yeah, they play a lot of soccer. You know, like we play pickup basketball, they play pickup soccer games.
Safin getting on himself a little bit about missing that passing shot.
That's the mental toughness I'm talking about. I mean, it was a solid first volley from Sampras. Gotta focus. See, looking again, it's just, I mean, you can watch Murat Safin. It's the second point in a row. This is where the immaturity kind of starts to seep out. And Pete Sampras, he'll take advantage of it.
Hopefully that'll be something that he improves over the course of his career. He's only 20 years old. I mean, he turned 20 this January.
But when a guy like Pete throws in a couple of big first serves, I mean, there's many times nothing you can do about it. And you just got to say, hey, that was a good serve and walk to the other side.
You know what? That's like you said, experience. You got to get beat up a bunch of times and realize, hey, that's you trying the best you can. Get ready for the next point.
Pete Sampras with three consecutive first serves in, 4-all.
No, watch Murat, Mal, and it's every point he's lost now. He's shaking his head. He says bad body language. He has to stay positive because right now, Pete Sampras is ready to shut the door on this guy. See, he's bouncing on his toes. Positive energy now. The momentum clearly with Pete Sampras.
I know Safin will be trying to shut the door on Sampras, but will he be able to?
Much better body language this time. He misses basically a duck volley on top of the net. Comes right back strong.
Love 15. Second serve for Sampras.
Finally, a passing shot down the line. A positive energy from the Russian Safin. Stays down with it. He has the ability to go down the line. Stays turned. Sampras has to respect the cross-court pass. He has to reach for it.
The only thing Pete maybe could have done is hit that return a little bit deeper, but it was so low, and you got to give Safin credit. He hit a great passing shot, 15-all.
And a great serve, number 12 for Safin, his fourth in this third set, 30-15. You got to give him credit. He's hanging tough.
He would like nothing more than to be in the semifinals with a win over Pete Sampras.
Pete Sampras floating that topspin backhand a little long. Double game point, 40-15 for this man, Murat Safin. The body serve from Safin coming in strong. He holds on. 5-4, he is up. Match game for Safin when we come back. Pete Sampras will have the balls, and he'll be serving right after this. Third set action, Murat Safin, he is up 5-4. Pete Sampras serving. It is one set all. Pete Sampras trying to pull even in this match. It is match game. And Sampras coming up with a good first serve on the first point.
Pete Sampras already experiencing going the distance, winning in a tiebreaker in the third set. Talking about Canada Dry, Pete Sampras never winning a Canadian Open.
His best finish in 1995, losing to Agassi.
And I think now, because he won 7 Wimbledons, I mean, that takes a lot out of you. You know, coming, you know, right from the French, you're playing a long grass court season, a full month, busting it out. It takes you a while to recover. And I think really step right back into it. Come to the Canadian Open, where all the top dogs are, trying to feast on the big boys. It's been tough for him to recover and take out the Canadian.
Another ace for Sampras. Number 9 and the first one in this set. And back in 1995 when he made the final here, he also took a while to really get his game going. It wasn't until the U.S. Open, really, until he won an event that summer where he beat Agassi in the final.
Yeah, Agassi was the guy on fire in 1995.
Went into the U.S. Open with like a 25-26 match win streak.
One of the knocks on the U.S. hardcourt season is you play maybe too much. I mean, Agassi did go in with all those wins. You know, he was like burned out by the final. He said he had nothing left in the gas tank. Where, you know, Sampras, okay, he lost a couple of Canadians and this, and he kind of had some fresh legs going into the Big Daddy in New York City.
Second serve, 40-15. Good hands up at the net from Pete Sampras. He holds on. No one can break serve yet here in the third set. 5-all, Safin to serve. See what kind of nerves the young Russian has.
I hate when players, especially young players, talk to themselves. I mean, to really keep it focused, you know what you need to do. Start shaking their head, the shoulders drop a lot. I mean, it's already tough enough you're playing Pete Sampras. I mean, don't make it even any tougher. Cross court again, missing to the tape.
But Sampras getting a little more depth on that return, not far off the baseline.
When that second serve doesn't land deep into the box, Mel, he really has a chance to, Pete has a chance to really knife it, get a good piece of it. Good close, hits the overhead, Murat Safin attacks the net, picks up the garbage.
Murat Safin venturing to the net one of the few times in this match. 15-all.
Yeah. 30-15. 201Ks just bringing down pain from above.
And another big ace, number 13.
He just winds up, gets good torque from his lower body. Nice toss, doesn't let it get too high.
Serve and volley for Murat Safin. He holds serve, and he is up 6-5. Pete Sampras will be serving to stay in this match when we come back.
Tennis Masters Series Toronto. Murat Safin one game away from a semifinal berth against Wayne Ferrer, but Pete Sampras is serving. He is in a must-win game for Pete Sampras.
Now, your mentality, if you're Pete Sampras, when you're serving to stay in, get a high percentage of first serves in, continue the good play around the net, play your style of game, Pete Sampras winning style, Wimbledon style.
Sampras again giving it a long look. See if Safin can do anything with the second.
Good return of serve, getting right behind the ball, driving through the strike zone.
All Safin needs to do right now is think about getting these returns in the court. Don't give Pete Sampras anything free.
And even though he lost that point, at least he got the ball in the court and made Sampras hit the winner, Luke.
Safin able to really react. He was almost like he was going to the forehand side in the last minute, changed directions, stabbed at the backhand slice, made the shot, forcing Sampras into a difficult forehand.
15-all.
A soccer action.
Just long off of the racket of Pete Sampras.
Murat Safin hustling all over the court, making the return, making the passing shots. Right from here, Safin has to accelerate to the net. Bumps it, and Sampras can't get a hold of this volley.
And Murat Safin says yes. And he is 2 points from the match, 15-30. And Sampras not doing enough with that drop volley.
Sampras just didn't feel comfortable hitting that jamming forehand volley. He had to nail it cross court, deeper into the court, instead of the drop shot failed.
And Murat Safin, double match point to get into the semifinals to face Wayne Ferreira.
Blistering passing check just wide, but I'm impressed with the way he's making his returns. He's making Sampras hit volleys.
One match point saved by Sampras. Safin gave a long look over to his coach, Alexander Volkov, after that missed pass. He has one more match point. And Pete Sampras down double match point. What does he do? He gets two first serves in, one of them an unreturnable.
Right in the backhand pocket of Murat Safin. Alexander Volkov shouting instructions to his man. Sweet drop volley. He's able to stretch out and carve right underneath the ball, adding the backspin. Here's the first volley, nice and deep. Now Sampras lunges out and kisses it cross court. Racket heads up. See how he carves underneath it, Mel? Adding the extra underspin.
Pete's first serve missed in the last 4 points. Game point.
That's unlucky from Sampras because he really forced the issue on that second serve. He had a nice floater, but it jammed him right in his body.
Looked like he was a bit indecisive, not knowing whether to hit a forehand or a backhand.
I am so impressed with the way Safin is returning this guy's serve. It's unheard of to really return this guy's serve at such a high level, standing inside, going after him. Watch how Safin starts on his toes, moves forward. Short backswing, makes good contact.
Once again, Sampras forced into digging his way out of that volley. Getting down, getting dirty.
Pete Sampras with a great second serve out wide, and Safin, we saw him earlier stretching out wide on that forehand return and ripping a winner. At that point, Sampras able to stab at the volley and get back to game point. Now he's missed three first serves in a row.
Sampras is just so confused when that ball comes back time and time again. That second serve, clearly over 100 miles an hour at 181 Ks. This drop shot just doesn't have it. On grass, that's a great shot. But on hard courts, it bounces too high. And Safin runs it down.
Safin still 2 points away from the semifinal. But more importantly, Sampras is serving.
From the Russian.
And off of a first serve.
It's showtime now for Murat Safin.
Match point number three for Safin.
Tell me that Pete Sampras doesn't want this. The extra effort. The net court off the return of serve. Pete Sampras coming in. Recognize it's short. He's got to run. Scramble. Good feel. Safin has a stab. Watch the reaction. Good balance. Good composure. Now he has to dart to cover. Safin just can't get a handle on it. On match point.
And a little bad fortune for Safin with that net cord. Many times those balls just drop right over and die. But back to deuce.
One of the best matches of the year. Safin can't get a hold of that forehand return.
This is the kind of tennis I expected out of the two of these guys. But I wasn't quite sure how long Safin would be able to play this kind of tennis. Second serve for Sampras to get into a third set tiebreak.
That double fault is forced by Murat Safin's ability to return the serve of Pete Sampras. Pete Sampras wasn't serving and volleying on that second serve. He was serving to stay back.
And that's one of the few times Pete Sampras has chosen not to serve and volley. Double fault number three. Three match points for Safin in this game. Two game points for Sampras thus far.
That's the mental toughness from the champion, Pete Sampras. You hit a double fault, you compose yourself, you come back with a major strike.
Game point number three for Sampras, still trying to get into the tiebreak. This packed crowd is now getting on their feet in appreciation for the tennis that these two guys are offering.
Now it's time for Safin to focus as we see Pete Sampras escaping out of Alcatraz down match points.
You think that was a bit of a sigh of relief on Sampras' part?
No doubt about it.
Sampras 2-0 in third set tiebreaks this year. One of those third set tie breaks was in this tournament in the first round against Frenchman Michael Yadro. First serve from Safin, 1-0. Safin.
Safin on his toes. Good positive energy.
Oh, see, you return. He just, oh, that's frustrating. Safin should have been inside the court, being offensive.
And for the second time in a row, Pete Sampras choosing not to serve in volley on the second serve.
Afraid of the return of Murat Safin.
One all.
The young gun, I'm sorry, Mal, just in position now with the mini break. Take your time, buddy.
Safin to serve. 2-1.
Oh, a little luck. He lifted off a bit too soon. The cosmonaut, as Alexander Volkov watches. Murat Safin.
It's a shot we see out of Pete Sampras quite often. And he did get the good fortune on the net court. Safin holds on, winning both of his serve points. He is leading 4-1.
You know, Safin's heart is just racing right now. It would be so easy just to rush into that serve. Instead, he takes his time, composes himself, executes a nice winning serve.
Is severely on Sampras.
Ace number 10 for Sampras. And didn't I say just a little while ago, when the pressure is on Sampras and he needs a serve, where does it go?
Down the middle. Texas T-Bone. And this is a great matchup because the ATP right now is really building up the young guns that we're seeing. It's the young gun in Murat Safin versus the old guard in Pete Sampras.
Another big ace right up the tee for Sampras. Pulls 1 point behind. 4-3. Safin still up a mini break.
Go, Pete.
The Michael Jordan of the game of tennis, Pete Sampras, coming up with the great shots when he needs it.
The second serve for Sampras.
Oh, is that pretty? That serve was bouncing really high too, and Sampras caught just in time to see Paul Anacone impressed by the smashing and crashing ability of Sampras. But here's the drop volley. He gets down with it, has a little side spin that puts it out of range. Here's the ripping forehand pass. Look at this, he gets down with it, gets down with it, good.
Not much else Safin could have done, 4-all. And with that backhand volley, Safin, he is still, again, 2 points away from this match. Pete Sampras serving 4-5.
Safin was smart, didn't get anxious on that shot. Drove it deep into the corner, forcing Sampras into a weak reply.
This is getting pretty good. I'm enjoying this.
Oh, that was close. Going to the body of the Russian Murat Safin. Sampras being smart with his play.
Good eye, Pete. Good eye.
See, right, a good jammer. A good jammer. When you're playing a big, tall guy, it's good to go into the body.
There's a show of how tennis is a game of inches. Second serve for Sampras. Will he stay back?
How How many times have you seen him go out to the forehand of Murat Safin? There's a scouting report for sure in the pocket of Paul Anacone. I'm Murat Safin, and Sampras is using it.
You just want to go to the net once.
That is to go out to the forehand wing if you get a chance on the return side.
And now Pete Sampras with his first match point.
A monster serve right down into the body.
And the players will change sides for the second time at 6 points all. Murat to serve one more point.
Can't say how much I'm impressed. I mean, it's amazing how this guy's been able to compose himself to have so many opportunities, match points. Second set, he has had a chance to break, to go up, a set and a break. He's battling the Pete Sampras.
And Sampras, with that error from Murat Safin, an inopportune error.
Well, he had the shot. It's the shot he had to take. He had to drive it deep. Just missing it long.
And now Sampras with his second match point, but he is serving. Will he go up the tee?
Now you picked it, baby. I want your scouting book.
Second serve.
Mal, are you happy with this match now? Are you into it?
Oh, I am into this match, and it looked as if Pete Sampras went for an ace, just flat out went for an ace on that second serve, and he went over to change rackets. It appeared as if that racket he was using, the string was about to break. Obviously, you don't want that to happen in a tiebreak in this situation. 7-all.
To kick himself because he had to hold down the line wide open. He had to hustle and nail it. But watch how he just casually comes up to it. He could have drilled this with two hands. Sampras all over that high backhand, creating another match point for the Wimbledon champion.
Match point number 3 for Sampras. Second serve. Look for Pete to attack.
Cross court once again. The crowd is on their feet.
And Murat Safin showing absolutely no nerves.
Another. So solid.
Another big backhand cross-court passing shot. 8 points all. And a service winner from Safin gives him another match point. His 4th.
Lots of slice to toss a little bit to the right as he carves around it. Gets around that ball to create the slice to bust it out wide.
And Pete Sampras throws in his 5th double fault of the match, 2 in this tiebreak alone, and in the best match of the tournament, Murat Safin, the 20-year-old Russian, playing the match of the year for him, taking down Pete Sampras in 3 sets, 6-4, 3-6, and 7-6 in the 3rd set tiebreak.
A great step for Murat Safin to overcome such a great champion. He had so many opportunities. He comes in and fights it off and wins.
Well done, Murat Safin. You are in the semifinals. And Murat Safin is into the semifinals with a 6-4, 3-6, 7-6 great match victory over Pete Sampras in this quarterfinal. He is in his first hard court
Masters Series semifinal of the year. Join us tomorrow at 4 p.m. Eastern Time on ESPN for semifinal number one, and then tomorrow night at 1 a.m. right here on ESPN2 for the second semifinal of the Masters Series from Toronto. Next up on ESPN is Up Close. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. For more, log on to ESPN.com. For Luke Jensen and all of us here at ESPN, I am Malavia Washington saying good night, everybody, from Toronto, and well done to you, Murat Safin. You are in the semifinals tomorrow against Wayne Ferreira. Great job.